Ciao to everybody.
Now, I've just been very cruel to a little girl down there who wants this little girl down here was asking, how can I get autographs? And I said, I'm sorry, it's impossible, but maybe
after I come.
Would you just the one? Okay, him? Right. Thank you, gets me out of trouble.
No problem, ciao, great. A lot of people, ciao.
In the weather. How are you after that unfortunate incident?
Yeah, I'm fit. I'm okay. I'm like just here.
Bruce Fingerdale.
But no problem. Yeah, you know we have in the Dainese leather we have a good airbag.
Yep.
That save my shoulder and the shoulder of Nikki.
Nikki said Dainese did a good job.
Yeah.
What happened? It was the same place you crashed last year.
In the warm up.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have some problem with the front grip, especially in braking. And the last chicane is very tricky, it's very difficult because you have to brake hard on a compression.
Yeah.
And when you go over crest, the bike unload the tire and lose the front. So
if you get to see the pictures from behind the bike, the second set of pictures, you see exactly what happens.
Yes.
The side on does not show so
yeah,
much.
Yeah, the imaging from behind is exactly this. So.
But you're uninjured and...
No.
But Jerry is working till midnight. Yes.
Jerry is working till midnight for try to be less slow tomorrow, and we hope for the rain. You know.
Hooch. Some of them booed.
No. Maybe for the fun is better dry. Yes.
Yeah.
Especially for follow the race, for don't arrive at the race at the end of the race all wet. So
it is amazing.
For us, it's better on the wet.
Nobody understands this Ducati carbon chassis, aluminium chassis. Perez last year, you fastest in the wet, carbon. Nikki here, fastest lap of the race. Le Mans, fastest lap of the race. No matter what you make it out of, it's good in the wet.
It's and bad in the dry. Yes, no, it's something in the bike because the Desmosedici is fantastic on the wet. And the incredible thing is the where we are very, very fast on the wet, like T2, T3, we are very, very slow on the dry.
Yes.
So our good thing on the wet, unfortunately, are our bad thing on the dry. So,
yes.
But sincerely, we don't know why.
I'm just keeping on the little girl who's going to get your autograph.
Ah, okay, fantastic.
Sure.
Okay.
Because she asked the question on the microphone, how could she get autographs? I said, you can't, and she was so disappointed that we blackmail you when you arrive. So that's it.
Okay.
We will do it. So. Really, Valentina, you want the rain tomorrow, yes?
No, with the rain, I can do a better race, fight for some important position. With the dry, we have to improve because we need some tenth in the rhythm, and we try to find for tomorrow. But anyway, we are unfortunately not fighting for the podium, for the important position. Yeah.
Yeah. Can we talk about Casey? His retirement. Did it come as a shock to you?
Yeah, I have some rumor in the paddock, but sincerely, I don't expect. Or maybe that minimum make another season, but he decides like this. So it's a pity to lose a great rider, a great rival.
A very fast.
Yeah.
On
yeah,
anything.
Yeah. Maybe it will be more easy for us without him.
At which point, I have to ask you. What are you going to be riding next year?
Ah, good question.
I try.
Sincerely, at the moment, I don't know. We work very hard on the Ducati and especially in the at home, and we're waiting for some new stuff more or less half of the season in Laguna Seca, I think, and we hope to arrive closer to the other factories, and until that moment I don't want to decide nothing from for next year. If also after next step we are so slow, I don't know.
Is it possible? I mean, you always in the past, you were a one-man team. 125, 250,
yep.
Astro Azzurro 500. Is it even remotely possible you will... Ah, first, let's do the important thing.
Go ahead, darling.
What's your name?
Marcella.
Hello, Marcella. Would you like Valentino's autograph on your programme? Shall I hold that? Right. Let's get hold of it and keep this proper. You are a lucky girl. And a photo, please. There you are, my dear. Thank you so much. Sorry, I could only get you one. Cheers. Right, that's the autograph thing done. Thank you for that, Valentino. And we're going to ask you to sign the guitar for the Simoncelli Foundation as well,
please. Yeah, for sure, no problem.
Which, that'll be an emotional day, I think, at Misano.
Yeah, for sure. And also now the track is called with the Marco name, and for sure, come back in Misano. Will be very, you know...
Emotional,
yes, but it's a great pity to don't have Marco here with us, especially sharing the day at home, go with the motocross bike, you know, so...
I'm sure. Mate, thank you very much on a very busy day for coming to see the fans. It's
lovely. But here is a show. Thanks. First, it looks like a concert, you know, in front of this.
Like a festival.
Like a rock star. And great thank you to all my fans, because also here in UK are a lot, and great pleasure. And we hope to come back with some good results, some funny races.
Valentino Rossi, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Ciao, Valentino. And Valentino will now sign the guitar, which will go on sale. Martin Finnegan, lead singer of the Rainbands, with a rather trick Fender Stratocaster. Is she back down there yet? Or has she fainted? That is the last autograph request. We're doing one only. I'm sorry. Good, great stuff. And Valentino, as ever, a great sport. He's had